morning. It's Monday, January 11th, 2021. I'm Russell, and this is Rocky Road Devotions, a few minutes of help for today's journey. Our devotion today is entitled Grounded, and our scripture is Psalm 69. Save me, O God, for the floodwaters are up to my neck. Deeper and deeper I sink into the mire. I can't find a foothold. I'm in deep water, and the floods overwhelm me. I am exhausted from crying for help. My throat is parched. My eyes are swollen with weeping, waiting for my God to help me. O God, you know how foolish I am. My sins cannot be hidden from you. The pathos of a king despised by the masses, headed for ruin and drained of all emotional and spiritual strength, pleading to the silent heavens for relief, is heart-shredding. This was David, the king of Israel, loved by God, lauded by the people, and ultimately fallen from the heights of splendor. When a ruler falls, it's more than just a brief news cycle. When a king falls, historians realize their job security has risen. In David's case, the fall was a personal misstep, a poor choice which allowed his humanity to replace God's will as his governor. David's prayer, "O God, you know how foolish I am," claims his personal responsibility for the depths to which his relationship with God has fallen. To his credit, David does not blame God or anyone else. He accepts the full weight of his sin. King David described his situation as being up to his neck in floodwaters, sinking deeper and deeper in the muck of his own choosing. As I was reading this psalm, I could not keep from seeing Donald Trump's image on David's throne. Edgy does not describe the angst of this situation. Mr. Trump's precarious hold on the presidency these past months has been a collective holding of breath for the nation. I'm a certified news junkie, but of late it's hard to turn on the news channels. I've not been a fan of the way President Trump has governed, but I'm even less a fan of the turmoil which has been the result. Misguided loyalists of an unwell ruler storming the halls of Congress is a terrible way to hold a eulogy for an administration. Yet, perhaps, it is fitting. The people spoke 4 years prior, and now the people must dine on those words. Yet there's something of a glimmer to which we can turn our attention. It's the hope of course correction over total disintegration. President Thomas Jefferson was in favor of revolution as a perpetual cleansing agent for our experiment in self-governance. To be certain, Jefferson did not advocate bloody revolution. Rather, he favored a revolution of ideas over legislative paper piles. Rather than build storehouses of legal ropes with which we bind ourselves to King David's melees of unanswered prayers, an entanglement of rules that overburden a society, our third president favored letting freedom ring, starting over with nothing but fresh-faced commitment to liberty. It's difficult to keep a noble dream alive, let alone a dishonorable desire. And it's not for me to theorize on whatever drove Mr. Trump's imagination and energy towards the presidency and induced such fanatic allegiance by his base of political support. I'm not qualified to explore that rabbit hole. But of the resultant unraveling of the 45th president's leadership, I surmise much will be written and debated about in the coming years. Of this I'm certain. It will not be pretty or flattering. But I do offer one hopeful perspective. This quadrennial experience of the brass ring to be grasped, a door open to the Oval Office and unquestionably the most powerful seat on earth, is neither for the faint of heart nor for those with a short supply of character. Neither is it a place for personal aggrandizement. It's a place for those who would remember King David's confession, "O God, you know how foolish I am." It's playing out in a very public and excruciatingly painful manner that the American public will not abide those who can't or won't pray that way. One last thought. I take no pleasure in having written these words. Only God and time will reveal whether they're true or not. If my assessment here is true, it's a sad truth of the grounding of reality. If untrue, time will blow away these words like an errant king's dalliance. For you today, pray for the new president to be inaugurated. Number 46 has a tough act to follow. You chew on that as you hit the rocky road. Have a blessed day.